Local news, national news, even feel-good news. Delivering the topics that are relevant to you.
That's why I listen to Joe. He covers it all.
The Joe Kelley Show on WDBO.
See, that is the thing, is we cover it all. There is no topic that is taboo for us. There is nothing that's off limits. There's nothing that we won't discuss. If it's relevant, if it's happening in our community, we're going to discuss it. And first of all, welcome to the show. We're glad to have you. And I want to welcome our first guest to the show, and that is Joseph Clark. Hello, Joseph. How are you, sir? Hang on. Is Joseph potted up on the board in there? Stand by, Joseph. We're having a technical thing. We're training someone new on the board tonight, and our official trainer just walked out. All right. Are you there with me, Joseph? Okay. Joseph, are you there with me?
Yes, I am.
Okay. We will edit all of this out in post-production, so don't worry.
Okay. It's all good, Joe. It's all good.
We're terribly, terribly sorry about that. Joseph Clark is the CEO of Gay Days Incorporated. Yes, he is. He's the guy that's in charge of that. And today begins Gay Days in Orlando, and I was reading about this today, and I don't know a lot about Gay Days. I know that it's a thing. I know that it happens every year, and that it seems to be associated with Disney, but it's not actually associated with Disney, and there's a lot more to it. But what I really wanted to talk to you about, a variety of things here tonight, Joseph. But first, as you are certainly aware, there have been some of these civil rights groups and some LGBTQ groups that have said that gay people should not come to Florida, that it's a hostile state to homosexual men and women, to people in the LGBTQ community. So what are your thoughts then as you head into this year's Gay Day with that warning about coming to our state?
Yeah, I mean, I think the warning, to clarify, is much more than do not come to the state. It's just be aware that there are parts of the state that you may not be treated well. And that's something, being a Florida resident, I mean, I can say there are parts of the state that I would not go in anyways. So now it's just empowered people more and more in the state to lash out against the LGBTQ plus people. And it's affected attendance of our event. It's affected businesses, those of us that have a gay-owned business. Beyond having a large gay event like this, we're seeing it through and through.
What do you think how do you expect this year's attendance to be compared to the previous years?
You know, I think the weekend is going to tell us what that looks like. A lot of our reservations came in late, but there was a lot of feedback about people not feeling safe coming to Florida or not wanting to support Florida because they felt as if they were not welcome.
And I'm sure you've looked at the weather forecast. It's not going to be really good weather through Sunday either. So you've got that issue. And I know a lot of your events are going to be outdoor events. So that's going to, the weather is not going to cooperate a whole lot.
The team jokes around all the time. It wouldn't be Gay Days without rain because it happens every year.
Right.
We're keeping an active eye on the storm. I know there was just a recent update. So once I'm done talking to you, Joe, I get to go get briefed on that from the head of my medic team. I think it's actually going to be a beautiful weekend. Today it was overcast, but it is gorgeous outside. The temperature is perfect for what we want.
And you've already alluded that you're a Florida resident. You live here, so that's obvious that of why you lead Gay Days here in Florida. But have you ever considered moving that out of the state? I mean, would another state be more receptive to that?
Not moving the event. I actually tell people this all the time at conferences, that I would never move the Orlando event the first weekend in June out of the state. What we are looking at is expanding on the event, and well before any of this excitement in Florida started happening, we were just looking at extending the event. And so our next added event we're looking at is in 2025, and we've already picked a city. We haven't announced it, but it will not be the first weekend in June. It's going to be a different time of year and a different type of event.
Interesting.
So no, we are not going anywhere. And that's the entire point to messages that I've put out there. We are here. in a sense, the old words of we're here, we are queer. Yeah, we're not getting put back in the closet. And no matter what happens, we will continue to get together to have this event and bring everybody together.
I'm sure, again, I don't need to tell you that there has been a bubbling hostility. There has been a lot of controversy in the news. We have seen major corporations like Bud Light and Target and Walt Disney that have taken social positions that a lot of conservatives and a lot of Americans just don't find to be to their liking. What is your message to those people tonight?
I would say if you don't like it, then don't buy it, right? If you don't like what's happening with Target and their Pride Wear collection that they have out, then don't buy it. You don't have to buy it. But we go back to the cancel culture that's just got to stop. The inacceptance of things that just need to stop in the country and around. I come from a house of respect to everybody. You may not agree with what they're doing, but you still need to have respect for people. And that's not what's happening. Yeah. I'm sorry you're offended by stuff that is not offensive out there. But what about me?
You and I come from the same house of respecting other people and you know, I say this all the time, both on the radio and off the radio. But, you know, the Bible tells us to love our neighbors, but you can't love your neighbors if you don't go out and meet them. If you don't talk to your neighbors, you can never love them. And that's why I love talking to you and to others that I may or may not agree with. But I still enjoy the conversation and getting to know my neighbors. Is there any concern? And again, yeah. I kind of go back to the hostility that some people are experiencing right now. What is your level of concern about safety this year compared to previous years?
I mean, I would say that this would definitely fall up there into a more cautious year for us. We've always had a very good security plan in place, and we continue to have that. I won't go in detail because what's the point of security if it is all out there? But it's a possibility. But ultimately, that's why we buy out a host hotel. So we create that environment. So we have every room in this hotel, with the exception of a few that are with a corporation, so that our guests can feel comfortable. We've got people all around this property to ensure that those protesters aren't coming on site, right? That we do our best to try to ensure safety for our guests.
And extremes, excuse me, hope to get my driver's license soon. there are extremes on both sides of this issue. There are extremes on the conservative issue. There are extremes on the LGBTQ issue. Do you have any concerns about any of the participants in Gay Days this year that might be misbehaving or might be lashing out at the state of Florida or at Governor DeSantis or anything like that? And has there ever been a history of that?
No, we've never seen a history of that. And we've had different organizations stand up against us. You know, the Jerry Falwells of the world have stood outside of Disney. The signs have been out there to stop people going to Disney, all of that. But our guests are actually really well-behaved guests. We like to have a fun time, but ultimately we're well-behaved, which is why we've been at the DoubleTree for so long. And we left briefly, but we're back. And the hotel staff is excited about it. There are team members here that come back for it. You know, are there the few? I believe there's a few in every group that's out there. But ultimately, we're here to have a fun time. And to come together as a family. It's like a big family reunion is what we throw.
Oh, yeah, I can see that. I'm sure you can imagine that there are some families that want to go to Disney or that may be going to Disney or I say Disney, but it's not just Disney that you guys go to. In fact, I looked at your schedule of events this week as I was getting ready for this phone call. And, I mean, you guys have a lot of events at a lot of different venues. I mean, there may well be, you know, conservative families with young children that haven't had that discussion yet with their children. You know, mommy, why are those two men holding hands? Why are those two men kissing? Why are those two women? I mean, you can certainly understand that, you know, as we alluded to earlier in this conversation, not everybody's going to have the same beliefs. Not everybody's going to have the same feelings that you do, that attendees of Gay Days will. Certainly you can understand that some families don't want to be exposed to that.
I have understanding to a point, though. My question would come to, why is that even a question that's being asked at that point? You know, why are those two men holding hands or kissing right there? If we go back to the broad statement of love is love. And yes, my first Gay Days I ever attended as a guest, you know, there was the moving, which still gives me goosebumps talking about it right now, the sea of red shirts at Disney. But at the same time, too, yes, I saw a father with his child who had a red shirt on, taking them back to the hotel because they were going to change because they didn't want to be associated with it. Right. That is a reality. And trust me, at Magic Kingdom, it's not this big lewd behavior that's happening there. I mean, it's Disney World, for God's sakes, and there is a respect to that. But it's the much deeper issue, in my personal opinion, of why is it even a question of why are they kissing? Why are we not teaching acceptance into everything from an early age? Whether you agree to it or not, we go back to Christianity and what you talked about in loving thy neighbor. That's where I get stuck up.
Well, and for what it's worth, I mean, if I've got young children, which I don't anymore, but if I had young children, I wouldn't want to see a heterosexual couple, making out at Disney or anything else like that either. So I there are just certain things that we don't want our children exposed to at different age groups. You know, we don't want them to see and learn certain things until their hearts and minds are able and willing to understand things.
I absolutely agree with that statement. I think what key about the entire thing is equality, which is what has been fought for, you know, with LGBTQ+ rights, is that equality. Why is it okay for you to talk about a heterosexual female to talk about her husband? But if I was at work, if I was a school teacher, I can't talk about my husband. But where is the equality in all of this? It's have your cake and eat it too. And that's just not, that's just not okay.
We are talking to Joseph Clark. He is the CEO of Gay Days Incorporated. If you want to check out the website, it's gaydays.com. You've got several websites. And now I regularly during Gay Days, I will inform our listeners. I'll say, hey, don't forget this week is Gay Days. And I say that without judgment. I say that without any intention other than letting, you know, people know, hey, if you are going out to Disney today, or if you're going out to Universal today, or if you're going out to SeaWorld today, you guys are having events at all those parks. You know, this is Gay Days Week, and you may well encounter a large throng of homosexual men and women that are going to be out there. And I like to just, that way people have the option of saying, you know what, I think we'll skip today, just like that family you mentioned that went home and changed shirts on that day. You know, I think the more information, the better. By me saying, hey, it's Gay Days this week, that lets any of our homosexual listeners and members of the LGBTQ community know, oh, maybe that's something I want to do. But conversely, it also lets conservatives and others know, hey, maybe we'll skip going to the theme parks this week.
But I believe the ironic part about all of that, Joe, is that on the converse side, just because it's not an event with a bunch of people wearing red shirts, I can assure you that at those theme parks, for example, there are gay people around.
Yes.
You know, so I understand what you're doing, but ultimately, we're everywhere.
Yes.
You know.
Yeah. Whoever came up with that slogan, oh, so many years ago, we're here, we're queer. Who knew how applicable that could be in so many different circumstances?
Yes, so much.
Well, Joseph, it's nice talking to you. Joseph Clark is the CEO of Gay Days Incorporated. Again, the website is gaydays.com. And do with this information what you will. It's very nice talking to you, Joseph, and I hope the weather holds out for you. I hope everybody is safe and enjoys their time here in Central Florida.
I appreciate it, Joe. Thank you for your time.
Yeah, man. Have a good night. It's 520 here on the Joe Kelley Show. You can join me at 844-580-WDBO. It's 844-580-9326. You can use the open mic in the WDBO app. Coming up next, Ron DeSantis. Man, I'm loving Ron DeSantis's interactions with the media, as Ron DeSantis literally says to a reporter, "What? Are you blind?" Hang on. You'll hear that next on WDBO. Stay there.
This is WDBO 107.3 FM and AM 580, Orlando's news and talk.
I'm a gay Republican here in Orlando. I don't fit in a lot of areas. That's fine. I'll go by the beat of my own drum. A lot of people think it's an attack on drag queens, gays. There's never been an issue with any of it until they try to bring kids into it. Don't sexualize kids. Let it be a parent's decision if they want to attend drag things in school. Leave kids alone. Stop playing victim. And stop letting the media twist it for their own agenda. Live and let live.
Very well said. Thank you for that. Open mic. You can also call 844-580-WDBO. Let's go to Pat in Lake Mary. Hey, Pat, you're on WDBO. How are you?
Did you leave me?
No, go ahead, Pat. I got you now.
Okay. This will be my 6th year of being an annual pass holder and going to Disney all year long. I have never seen any problems during the month of June. So I don't, you know, that they're making so much fuss. Because guess what? Gays are in the parks every day of the year.
Yeah.
You know, it's no different. But I do agree with the open caller, because I do have several gay friends who do not want to be associated with the last half of the alphabet, because they feel that, you know, it's not right.
Well, and it's especially when it's targeted towards our kids. When you're making, you know, pride wear for children, when you're making, you know, that kind of stuff, when you're teaching that in school, when you've got graphic books in school showing, you know, sex, that's problematic.
The one way I explain it is, you are asking kids who believe that once a year a man in a red suit climbs down their chimney, leaves them gifts all over the world. Easter time, this bunny hops around, leaving chocolate candies for kids all over the world. And if you lose your baby tooth, stick it under the pillow, because there's a tooth fairy that's going to come put money under your pillow. So it's too early to be trying to teach these kids these things. Let them be kids for a while.
Yep. I'm with you there, Pat. Thank you so much for your call. I appreciate that. Governor Ron DeSantis has been in New Hampshire today. And he was at a campaign event. He had given a speech at a small event. That's how it works. And then he was working the crowd. He was walking through the crowd, shaking hands with everybody he could find, taking pictures with everybody, talking to people in the crowd. And a reporter walks up and says, "How come you don't take any questions from voters?" I mean, I cannot imagine a more ignorant question to pose of Ron DeSantis, and you're going to hear Ron DeSantis's reaction to this reporter coming up right after our news at 5:30. So stand by for that. It is coming up next. You can join me at 844-580-WDBO or use the open mic in the WDBO app. We will continue the Joe Kelley Show straight ahead on WDBO.
Weather brought to you by ProTech Air Conditioning and Plumbing Services. This is WDBO 107.3 FM and AM 580, Orlando's news and talk. breaking news to lively debates, covering the issues that matter to you.
I make it a point to listen to Joe Kelley when I need to fully understand what's happening in the news.
Now, the Joe Kelley Show on Orlando's News and Talk, WDBO.
You know, I just saw a commercial, an anti-Ron DeSantis commercial on Fox News. And it was saying that Ron DeSantis was in favor of a 23% national sales tax. This is what I hate about negative ads is they don't tell the whole story. The 23% national sales tax was to replace the federal income tax. So it's not as if Ron DeSantis wanted to add a 23% national sales tax to everything and just tax people more. He just thought that was a more fair way to tax Americans than an income tax. So just be mindful when you see negative campaign ads. And even if they, you know, cite, you know, the Orlando Sentinel on this date has said this or whatever, they leave out. They lie by omission. They lie via omission. That's what they do. Ron DeSantis in New Hampshire, surrounded by people. I mean, it is elbow to elbow. And some ding dong reporter comes up to Ron DeSantis and asks him why he doesn't take questions from voters. He's literally standing in a large crowd of voters answering their questions, posing for pictures with them and everything else. And this guy asked this question. Here's the scene.
Why not take any questions from voters, Governor, how come you're not taking questions from voters?
Stop coming up to me, talking to me. What are you talking about? I'm not here working with people. Are you blind?
What?
Are you blind?
I'm not blind.
Okay, so people are coming up to me, talking to me, whatever they want to talk to me about.
It was easier to hear when it wasn't on the radio. I think that might have been hard to understand. But he twice asks the reporter, are you blind? Are you blind? He says, what do you think I'm doing? I'm standing here talking to people. I'm taking questions from voters. So that was Governor Ron DeSantis in New Hampshire today. And we also have I've got this audio here for you. Today is something called Day Without Immigrants. Day Without Immigrants. And this is to protest the new Florida immigration law. And there was a big rally for this. And I tuned in for, 20 seconds or so to see what they were saying, to see what they were talking about. This is the Day Without Immigrants event.
Voy a decir en español y después la digo en náhuatl. Oh, corazón del cielo, danos hoy nuestra comida, tu paz, tu libertad y tu amor. Cuida mis hijos y cuida mi camino.
So as someone who is monolingual, I hadn't the slightest idea. I still haven't the slightest idea what she was saying. And I can't help but to think that having an event like this, a political event, to highlight what they think are Florida's inappropriate, unfortunate, regrettable immigration laws, I would think that doing that in English would probably be more effective than doing it in a foreign language. I don't know if I think she was speaking Spanish. I'm not quite sure, but I think she was speaking Spanish. But wouldn't that make better sense in English? And I think they're going to have a hard time from the majority of Floridians finding support for this. Thousands of Floridians are taking part in this protest today that they call a Day Without Immigrants. And the organizers are asking immigrant workers to stay home or to stay closed for the day today. It's all in protest of the Florida Senate Bill 1718, which limits social services for undocumented immigrants. It goes into effect on July 1st, a month from today. Governor Ron DeSantis touts the bill as the strongest anti-illegal immigration legislation in the country, doing things such as funding state transportation of immigrants to other states, penalizing those who employ undocumented immigrants, and requiring hospitals to collect data if they serve immigrants. All of these, I completely support that legislation. And there will certainly be some hardship in the early days of this legislation in July when it kicks in, because there will certainly be employers who will find that some of their employees aren't coming to work anymore because of this law. And frankly, there are going to be employers who are going to fire their undocumented immigrants because the employers don't want to be fined. So there are going to be some bumps in this road, but the ultimate goal is to make this state self-sustainable without a necessity for illegal immigrants or undocumented immigrants, which is something that every state should be doing. Every state should be making it more difficult, particularly since our border is so insecure, since our border is wide open, no matter what the Biden administration says about it. But since our borders are wide open, states have to do everything they can to get undocumented immigrants out of their states and either push them to other states or push them back to where they came from. Support this 100%. 844-580-WDBO. It's 844-580-9326. You can hit me up in the open mic and the WDBO app. Triple team traffic now with Paul Cross. How was our Thursday night drive shaping up, Paul?
Well, it's getting better right now, Joe. They've cleared up that crash, 535 northbound at Meadow Creek Drive, and we're still looking at brake lights westbound I-4 through Lake Mary, and then from Parr onto the 408 eastbound ramp, Sand Lake to 535 and Osceola Parkway into Champions Gate. It hasn't been as heavy as the last few nights have been, but I-4 eastbound also still pretty busy past the Disney exits. That's a no-brainer. It's like that every night. Up to speed through downtown, but then slow again, Parr to Lee and approaching Lake Mary Boulevard to the bridge. From the WDBO Triple Team Traffic Center, I'm Paul Cross.
So when July 1st gets here and this new Florida Senate Bill 1718 kicks into law, there will be changes here in Florida. You're likely going to be going to your fast food restaurants or to some of your restaurants and finding that they're going to be short-staffed. And frankly, they're all short-staffed right now as it is anyway. Workforce participation is way down. People are not working in so many jobs. There are so many job openings right now. It is ridiculous. But this is it is preposterous to me for people that are here illegally. They're undocumented. How dare you have a rally in which you protest our immigration laws? You have no right to protest our immigration law. You know, and as we discussed yesterday about the Bill of Rights and the U.S. Constitution, and a caller had said that the Constitution doesn't apply to people who are not American citizens. And that's not entirely accurate, as these undocumented immigrants today were able to have their freedom of speech, able to have their freedom of assembly. But it is laughable that you're going to stand here in our country and tell us that we're wrong. Can you imagine if we went to Mexico, if we went to Ecuador, if we went to Guatemala, and we plugged in a speaker and a microphone and decided to hold a big rally protesting Ecuador's immigration laws or Mexico's immigration laws? I don't even know if we would get the electricity to power a microphone, quite honestly. But Mexico or any other nation would laugh us out of their country. They're not going to listen to us about their immigration laws. Why in the world should we listen to undocumented illegal immigrants about our immigration law? You don't get a vote on this. You don't get to decide this. And they keep saying a day without immigrants. This has nothing to do with immigrants, and it has everything to do with illegal immigrants or undocumented immigrants. We love and value immigrants. I mean, we are the melting pot, the United States is. I remember learning that as a kid. I mean, we are unique as a nation like that we welcome people from around the world into our country. But the discussion here is about people who do it illegally. And if people, as part of that protest today, were here legally or are here legally, then what in the world are they protesting? Because the state has done nothing to make it harder on Americans, to make it harder on American citizens, or to make it harder on immigrants who are American citizens. So it's disingenuous to call this a day without immigrants when the reality is it should be called a day without illegal immigrants. I don't prefer to call them illegal immigrants. I prefer to call them undocumented. I don't think anybody is illegal. Their actions are illegal, but their mere existence is not illegal. But in this case, it's helpful to point out that it's the people who are here illegally that we care about, not people who went through the process and became legal residents of the state. What do you think? 844-580-WDBO. It's 844-580-9326. You can use the open mic in the WDBO app. Are you concerned that this immigration law, when it kicks in July 1st, is going to have a ripple effect at your place of business, where you work? Is it going to hit you in the breadbasket? Let me know. 844-580-WDBO.
The Joe Kelley Show on WDBO. The Joe Kelley Show on WDBO. Your next chance to win the WDBO payroll payout of $1,000 happens tomorrow at 8 a.m. during Orlando's morning news. Just listen for the keyword and then tap the payroll payout button in the WDBO app.
$1,000.
$1,000.
Get paid just for listening to WDBO.
This is awesome.
All right, they're calling it a day without immigrants. They had a big rally today here in Florida to protest what will be the July 1st start date of new immigration laws here in the state of Florida. The number 844-580-WDBO. It's 844-580-9326. Let's start with Tom, who's joining us out of Pinecastle. Hey, Tom, how are you?
Good. How you doing, Joe?
Good.
I've worked at Disney for a very long time, the banquet department, and we do a lot of gay weddings out there. And recently we did a gay wedding, and there were about 150 people. And most everybody was very, very nice as usual. However, these two, men were kissing in front of children. And some people are offended by that, in front of children especially. And then they had a drag queen come out as the primary entertainment. They invite people, including children, onto the dance floor with drag queens. A drag queen, I should say. And it's like, it's sometimes like offensive or over the top. And I just wanted to share that with you. And I think it's important to distinguish between the condition of being gay and the behavior. And I think that the behavior is one thing, the condition is another. As a Christian, as a churchgoer and so on, I mean, they teach you love everyone, including everyone.
That's right.
No matter what, you love everyone. And I just wanted to share that. It's the behavior that is questionable at this point in time, I think.
Tom, thank you so much. I'm so glad you called. I hate to cut you off. I'm just simply running out of time here. Charlie is in Eustace. You're on WDBO. Hi, Charlie.
Hey, Joe. New listener for me. I've been in the landscape contracting business for most of my life. And my brother also, he just sold his big company back in 2000. He had probably 180 to 185 Mexicans and like 40 or 50 Haitians. I don't care what.
Charlie, I am so sorry, Charlie. Your phone keeps cutting out, and I really want to hear what you have to say. Perhaps you'll call back in a few minutes here after the news at 6 o'clock. And I would love to get your take on the immigration law that is going to take effect in a month here in Florida. I'm Joe Kelley. We will continue straight ahead.
The Joe Kelley Show on WDBO. Now, WDBO 107.3 FM and AM 580. Triple Team Traffic.
Still have that crash on Kirkman and Major Boulevard, another on Orange Blossom Trail at Holden. And we're looking at some heavy delays on I-4 eastbound past the Disney exits. Looking still pretty good through downtown. You're going to touch the brakes again between Parr and Lee and then approaching Lake Mary Boulevard to the bridge. Having tech issues? No worries. Visit Refresh Computers, Central Florida's budget computer store. Visit Refresh Computers in Longwood or at refreshcomputers.net. From the WDBO Triple Team Traffic Center, I'm Paul Cross.
Weather brought to you by ProTech Air Conditioning and Plumbing Services. This is WDBO 107.3 FM and AM 580, Orlando's news and talk. Orange, Seminole, Osceola, and all of Central Florida. Join the conversation now by using the open mic in the WDBO app. Now, the Joe Kelley Show on Orlando's news and talk, WDBO.
So today is something that they call Day Without Immigrants, and that's really a misnomer. That is a lie in an attempt to sway public opinion, because it is not immigrants that Florida has a problem with. It's illegal immigrants that Florida has the problem with. And if you're just joining us, that's what we're talking about. 844-580-WDBO. It's 844-580-9326, or use the open mic in the WDBO app. We were talking to Charlie from Eustace in the last hour, and we had a bad connection. But, Charlie, I think you're back with us now. Hi.
Hey, Joe. Sorry about that. I just had some, I don't know, something wrong with my phone.
Yeah, what are you going to do?
This is my other being in the landscape business as long as I was, and my oldest brother, he had a huge company in South Florida. I don't know how they do it. Somehow they obtain this form that you have to have to submit to the payroll companies, and we can't hire them until they have that form. And how they get it, I don't know. Maybe this law has changed a little bit to where it's going to tweak it, but they're still going to find a way to be able to get paid.
Is that not part of a false document, scam?
They've had that false document scam since I started my landscape business in 1994. And it's an ongoing thing. They send probably 50 to 60% of what they earn home, and they're here until they build up enough money to retire on. Because I know a couple of my friends, they're from Yucatan. And hardworking guys, they can read blueprints, they can operate any kind of heavy equipment, and they live like paupers until they reach the dollar figure they needed to go home and stay. And they live a very good life down there with the money they make here.
Interesting.
They're gonna get around it.
And I'm sure, I have no doubt that many of them are hard workers and are good citizens or non-citizens, or they're good members of a community. Many of them also that are coming across the border are rapists and murderers and members of gangs. They're cartel members. There's been a rash lately of Chinese spies coming across our border. I mean, you understand I think we can both understand that there will be businesses who will try to cheat or skirt. I'm not saying that you or your brother are in that position, but something has to be done about the people coming across our border, and we have no idea who they are. Charlie, thank you so much, man. I'm glad you called back. I appreciate that. Let's go to Jerry in Orlando. Hey, Jerry, you're on the Joe Kelley Show. How are you?
Great. And yourself, Joe?
Very good.
I just want to let you know that I'm a big listener, and I think you're so cool. You probably already know that.
thank you.
The clip that you played earlier regarding the lady that was speaking Spanish,
yes.
It was Spanish.
Yes, okay.
And you did say that she should have, started, probably in English or something like that.
Here, let me play just a little clip of this so our listeners know what we're talking about. This was the event today, the Day Without Immigrants event.
Voy a decir en español y después la digo en náhuatl. Oh, corazón del cielo, danos hoy nuestra comida.
To which I suggested that it might be more effective if that was in English, not in Spanish.
Okay. So what she was saying was she's going to start it off in Spanish, and she was going to translate it. She was going to translate it in English. That's what she was saying start of it. Yeah, and then she said she wanted to thank God for the food, the freedom, and the love that was shown to them.
Oh.
So that's what she was saying.
Good.
Just wanted to point that out to you guys.
I'm glad you did, man. Today I learned, so that's awesome. Jerry, thank you so much, man.
Joe, thank you.
Yeah, have a great night. Let's go to Mike in Orlando. You're on WDBO. Hey, Mike.
Hey, Joe. Calling in regards to the immigration law, and I think it's a good thing that DeSantis is doing. I speak Spanish, and I agree with the previous caller. She was basically saying a prayer. But at the same time, my feeling is that if you're illegal, don't come to Florida. Go to where they want you. For the most part, I agree with the second caller who said that they take most of their money and they send it back to their home.
Yeah.
So they're not contributing to the economy. Basically, what they're doing is taking money. They live in apartments or homes of three or four families at a time, save that money, and send it back home. And the other issue is these people are not smart enough. Well, I shouldn't say it like that, but I deal with them a lot, and they're not very intelligent. They're not organized into doing something political like this, like what they're doing today. This is other organizers. These are other people who are organizing and basically doing it.
Someone else is pulling the strings, you're suggesting. And
absolutely.
And in this case, I mean, it could be a variety of interests. It could be the Democratic Party. It could be labor unions. It could be mass employers. It frankly could be theme parks. I mean, it could be a lot of different things. Of businesses that like taking advantage of illegal immigrants, and they don't want to see that come to an end.
Absolutely, sir.
Yep. Thank you so much, Mike. Man, I'm so glad you're listening. Thank you so much for calling. Let's go to DeBerry. Bill is on WDBO. Hi, Bill.
Hey, Bill. Joe, Bill. I'm Bill. You're Joe.
Hello. Nice to meet you.
Yes, sir. You know, I got a buddy of mine I work with. His name is John, and he's from Haiti. And he took 12 years to get his family from Haiti to the United States. He paid thousands of dollars. He went through all the right hoops. He did all the correct things. And his family is here now. They own three restaurants and here in the United States, but they did everything correctly. And that's all they have to do. No one's saying don't come. Just do it correctly. In addition to that as well, I want these people to understand that when they come, they're coming for jobs. But if they continue this process, the job market is going to be saturated by other people just like them, and they're going to be the victims of their very own venom.
Yeah, they may well be. You're absolutely right about that. Yeah,
all I got, man. Thank you. And I appreciate the show. Really enjoy it.
Thank you so much, man. I appreciate that a whole lot. A couple of open mics here, one taking issues with the employers.
This is Kevin from Apopka. If you own a business in Florida, you're a crook because nobody down here pays right. Nobody. These people don't want to lose their illegals because then they might have to pay an American actually enough money to live on. And they definitely don't want to do that in Florida. They are all crooks.
Right. If we can route out, if we can get rid of all of the undocumented immigrants, and keep all of the legal and documented immigrants here, I think the owners are going to find that they're going to have little choice but to increase their pay and to treat workers better. I think a lot of employers think that they can just treat workers like crap because they're illegal. And what are they going to do? Complain? Or what are they going to do? Call the police? I mean, they're not going to complain about their work conditions because they know that they are here illegally.
Joe, this is Ken from Orlando. I get so tired of people saying that if you're anti-illegal immigration, you're anti-immigrant. Nothing could be further from the truth. All we're saying with this legislation is if you're here illegally, you do not want to come to Florida. If you're here legally, we welcome you with open arms.
Yep, and that is a sentiment that I keep hearing.
Joe, I love you. I love your show.
Thank you.
You just hit the nail on the head when you just said this is about illegal immigration. I've heard this all day long. Oh, the immigrants are having this thing going on. We love our immigrants. We love people that do it the right way. Please, everyone, keep the word illegal or undocumented in there. Thank you.
Yeah, it does indeed make a difference.
Hey, this is Allison from Groveland. I legally came over here, and that's the only way it should be done. But I have friends that bought businesses over here from the UK. E2 visas is what they're on. And they can never hope to get a green card. They can be sent home at any time. Their business may not be making money. Even if they've been here 20 years, their kids could be born here, but they have to go home. How's that fair? It's disgusting. And they work and pay their taxes and employ American citizens.
You know, but the problem is we have two different economies going on here. We have the legit legal economy that's going on, that's measured, that gets taxed and everything else. And then we have the underground economy where, you know, drug dealers live, where undocumented immigrants live. And we've got to rid ourselves of the underground economy right now. And I don't think we're going to, you know, with all these arguments about, you know, what is a living wage and what is not a living wage, the rash of undocumented immigrants that we have in the United States will continue to suppress wages. Our wages will never go anywhere as long as we have a wide open border and we allow millions of undocumented workers to come across the border. Our wages will stay artificially low because cheap labor is coming across the border. The second we shore up that border and keep people from coming across it, and the second 50 states all get together and make it impossible for their state residents to employ undocumented immigrants, that's when we'll see wages finally start to increase across the United States. I mean, you can't tell me other than some business owners and you know, some extremely wealthy people, wages are not keeping up with the economy. Wages are not keeping up with inflation. And they're never going to catch up as long as we have an artificial economy that exists with undocumented workers. And that is at least one of the reasons why the Democrats want the border wide open like it is to be able to suppress wages, to keep the pay down. I mean, that would be something that I would think that if stereotypes were true, that would be something that Republicans would be guilty of. But the stereotypes aren't true. So the border's wide open and cheap labor is coming across the border. Cheap labor stifles innovation. It keeps companies from coming up with new technology. We talked about this recently, that even out in Plant City, they were having a hard time finding people to pick strawberries. Well, if you the farmers and the business owners aren't going to just let the strawberries die on the vine. They're going to innovate. They're going to come up with a plan. If they can't find cheap labor, they're going to find a cheap alternative. And while there was some initial cost involved, they have since built a robot, if you will. It looks a bit like a smaller Zamboni machine. And if I have to explain what a Zamboni machine is for non-sports fans, that's the machine that grooms the ice between periods in hockey games. So they built a machine that looks like a mini Zamboni, and doggone it, it picks strawberries. It never calls in sick. It never comes to work late. It never shows up hungover or drunk. It never has to worry about whether or not it's going to pass a drug test. This is all because of low wages stifling innovation. And they finally, without having enough workers, they innovated and they built a robot that would pick the strawberries for them. 844-580-WDBO. It's 844-580-9326. Or use the open mic and the WDBO app. Coming up next, one of the best deep fake videos that I have seen to date. And this one features Ron DeSantis. You'll hear it coming up next here on WDBO.
The Joe Kelley Show on WDBO. The Joe Kelley Show on WDBO. Your next chance to win the WDBO payroll payout of $1,000 happens tomorrow at 8 a.m. during Orlando's morning news. Just listen for the keyword and then tap the payroll payout button in the WDBO app.
$1,000.
Get paid just for listening to WDBO.
This is awesome.
By the way, if you wanna see what we look like, if you wanna see what the voices on the radio look like, we do have a live video stream that is on the WDBO Facebook page. I can tell you that some of us are extremely good looking and some of us are not. And it is up to you to decide which is which. Your mileage may vary. Your preferences may vary. You guys know what deep fake videos are, right? So I saw this deep fake today and I chuckled at it because it was so well done. And it's done from an episode of The Office, a show that I have never watched. But I still can appreciate some humor from it. But in this deep fake video, the audio of which I'm about to play, Ron DeSantis's face is seamlessly placed on the face of Steve Carell. So this is the Steve Carell character. It's Ron DeSantis's voice, even though DeSantis never said these words. This is how good this AI / deep fake stuff is these days. Take a listen.
One tiny mistake. I wore woman's clothes.
Are you wearing lady clothes?
What?
Are you wearing lady clothes? Those look like lady pants.
No, this is a power suit.
That there's a woman's suit.
I do not buy women's clothes. Do not make that mistake again.
I'm going to call Roy, man.
Okay.
This is going to make me feel better.
Now, I'd like to tell you that I could show you the video, that I could put it up somewhere where you can see it, but I tried earlier today, and it got taken down for copyright infringement, copyright issues, because it's owned by NBC Universal, and so they took it down. So I can't show you the video, but just if you were to search for a deep fake of Ron DeSantis as Steve Carell, perhaps you'll find it somewhere. Look on Twitter if you really want to see it, because that's where you'll likely be able to see it. But otherwise, I'm not able to post that anywhere. 844-580-WDBO. It's 844-580-9326. We're talking about illegal immigration here in Florida. Walter is joining us from Orlando. Hey, Walter, you're on WDBO.
Hi, how you doing, Joe?
Very good, thanks.
I like your show.
Thank you.
I got one quick question. I got nothing against Mexicans. You know, they're good people. There's some bad. My question is, who's going to build America now?
With this new immigration law, and as I mentioned, there is definitely going to be a bumpy road beginning July 1st. And until this gets sorted out with all the various employers and agencies and stuff across Florida, because in the short term, there may not be people to build America. There may not be people to pick the crops. There may not be people to put on rooftops. There may not be people willing to do jobs that we're told time and time again that Americans won't do. But ultimately, these businesses aren't going to let these positions go completely unfilled. They're just not. And walking into a McDonald's, man, do I love a Big Mac. And I went to a McDonald's on iDrive on Sunday or Monday. I don't remember which day it was. Saturday. Anyhow, everyone that takes your order is a kiosk. There are no humans taking orders at kiosks. This is one way they get around. They innovate. And that's exactly what other businesses are going to do when they don't have anybody to put their roofing shingles on. They will come up with robots that put on roofing shingles. People innovate. That's how this works. But it will take a while. I mean, it is definitely, I agree with you, it is going to be painful in the first few months, maybe the first few years of this new immigration law. More of your calls coming up at 844-580-WDBO.
Gulf of Mexico has been getting gradually better organized all day today. We're going to keep you posted. But right now, the forecast brings it south and toward the western tip of Cuba by the weekend and moving into some hostile wind environments. We don't think it's going to last very long. For us, we're still kind of on the edge of some of the moisture from it. So our rain chance holding at around 60% for the next couple of days. Probably more of a typical afternoon sea breeze storm pattern, really, all the way through the upcoming weekend. As we keep an eye on our new system in the Gulf, we'll keep you posted. From Channel 9, I'm Chief Meteorologist Tom Terry.
This is WDBO 107.3 FM and AM 580, Orlando's news and talk. Talk and discussion on the latest breaking national news.
Crude oil prices continue to fall.
Local news.
You're not going to have Disney have its own government in Central Florida.
And stories that matter to you. Use the open mic in the WDBO app and let your voice be heard on The Joe Kelley Show.
You know, as I mentioned, we got a video chat. If you want to join the video chat and see the behind the scenes here at WDBO and the Joe Kelley Show, just go to the WDBO Facebook page right now. One of our chat participants, Karen, who I adore, Karen writes, "Sometimes I feel so sorry for Joe Biden." And I got to tell you, I all the time feel sorry for Joe Biden. I truly do. This is elder abuse, if there ever was such a thing, of putting Joe Biden in that position. And if you don't know which Joe Biden story we're talking about that's triggered that, it was when Joe Biden fell today. If you haven't seen the video of it, I mean, it's sad. I mean, the guy's 80 years old. Think about your moms and dads, your grandmas and grandpas, and you're always worried about them having a fall. Taking a fall. I mean, falls can be extremely dangerous for 80-year-old people. And I don't know what it was that Joe Biden tripped on. Some people say there's a sandbag there. I'm having a hard time seeing that, but that just might be me. But he clearly tripped on something. And yeah, I feel sorry for him. It's that poor guy is being abused terribly in that position. Now, speaking about abuse, that doesn't mean that Joe Biden doesn't commit abuses of his own. And perhaps, today, I mean, when he keeps defending Hunter Biden as, you know, one of the smartest guys, one of the most honest guys he knows, I have to think that Joe Biden doesn't actually know anybody else then. And maybe today's absolutely, you know, brain dead Joe Biden is not as corrupt as he once was. Maybe he is. Who knows? But the White House was asked about corruption and public sentiment today. And the other White House spokesperson, John Kirby, you know, the competent one, Karine Jean-Pierre being the incompetent one. So the competent one was caught flat-footed and had really no answer for this question that was posed today at the White House.
There have been many developments in the House investigations into the First Family's international business dealings recently. There's one committee trying to get an FBI file alleging that President Biden took bribes. There's another IRS whistleblower who's alleging there's a cover-up in the investigation. Amid all of this, there was a Harvard-Harris poll this month that found that 53% of the public, including a fourth of Democrats, believe, quote, Joe Biden was involved with his son in an illegal influence peddling scheme. There's, of course, evidence that the president interacted with his relatives, associates from China, Mexico, Kazakhstan, Russia, and Ukraine. So what do you say to the majority of Americans who believe that the president is himself corrupt?
Okay, so hang on. So let's count the seconds here that elapse between the question and when an answer finally comes out of John Kirby's mouth.
...who believe that the president is himself corrupt.
Wow. Okay, hang on. I got to get back to where that starts. Here we go.
...who believe that the president is himself corrupt.
One, two, three, four, five, six.
The president has spoken to this. The president has spoken to this. And there's nothing to these claims. And as for the whistleblower issue that you talked about and the document, I believe the FBI has spoken to that. You're going to have to go to them on that.
Yeah.
Right. Let's go. Let's go.
And then they, and that's Karine Jean-Pierre, the incompetent one. And she is saying, all right, let's go. Let's go. And they literally walk out after that. But listen again to the question that the reporter, I don't know who it is, but he asks the question very smartly, if you will.
Mexico, Kazakhstan, Russia, and Ukraine. So what do you say to the majority of Americans who believe that the president is himself corrupt?
Yeah. What do you say to the, so he's not saying, you know, what do you think about the president being corrupt, or I think the president's corrupt. He's saying, what does the president think about the majority of Americans who think that he's corrupt? And for John Kirby to not take that question seriously. In fact, in the very beginning here, you can kind of hear him chuckle.
Wow.
Jesus. He goes, wow, Jesus. That's what Kirby says.
The president's spoken to this.
And you can hear him pounding his hand on the podium.
The president's spoken to this. The president has spoken to this. And there's nothing to these claims. And as
how dare you? How dare you, competent one? How dare you blow this off? You are flat out lying. If you're ignoring the polling numbers, if you're ignoring, I mean, the question wasn't is Joe Biden corrupt. The question is, how does Joe Biden feel about the majority of Americans thinking that he's corrupt? And all John Kirby wants to do is get out of this question as quickly as possible by saying, well, it's already been addressed. It's already been addressed and it doesn't need to be addressed any further. Or just ask the FBI. Yeah, because the FBI will certainly answer that. 844-580-WDBO. It's 844-580-9326. You can use the open mic and the WDBO app. Still talking about illegal immigration into the United States. We're not really focused on legal immigrants that are here, but on illegal immigrants that are here.
Joe, the other problem is that Bank of America accommodates these people by letting them send money back across the border with no fee whatsoever.
Yeah, and I don't know. I know that most banks offer that kind of services. I know that what is that place that's on every intersection, every corner, everywhere, Laurel? The money cashing places.
Amscot.
I mean, that, you know, that's what Amscot does as well. I don't know if they are required to do so or not allowed to do so or whatever the case may be.
Don't you think that crime will increase if people can't earn a living?
Interesting thought. So you're suggesting that if an illegal immigrant is here and they're not allowed to find a job, they can't find a job, they can't work in the state of Florida, that they're going to turn to crime to potentially feed their families or to feed themselves. You know, even if that is true, even if that were to become true, society cannot let threats from criminals dictate our laws, dictate our standards, dictate our ways of life. We cannot cower in fear of illegal immigrants, because they might rob us. It might happen. Yeah, you might be right. But we cannot let that deter us from doing what is right. And that is stemming the tide of the millions of people coming across our border without having any idea who they are or why they are here. I'm Joe Kelley. We'll take more of your calls and comments straight ahead at 844-580-WDBO.
The Joe Kelley Show on WDBO.
It's the Joe Kelley Show on WDBO. All right, Laurel, so I was out last night, as I do every night. If you're ever in downtown Orlando at night, anytime between like 10:30 and 11 or 11:30, odds are good I'll be out walking my dog at that time, my stepdog. And last night I was out walking my stepdog, and there is a dude sitting there who appears homeless. He looked filthy and homeless. So, but Arwen, my stepdog, goes right over to him, and I'm like, "Oh, Arwen, you're such a pest. You're gonna go talk to now. I got to talk to the guy." So then I'm talking to the guy, and we had a nice cordial conversation. And he, At the end of the conversation, I'm waiting to see if he hits me up for money. Now, when I go out and walk the dog at night, I never, ever, 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 ever take money with me. I always make sure that if I'm just out walking the dog, don't take money. I don't take my wallet. I don't take anything but my keys and a dog leash and my phone so I can take pictures of whatever the craziness I see out in the streets. So this guy hits me up for money. And I will tell you that as he hits me up for money, I glance down to his lap and I see that he's holding in his lap a stack of scratch cards.
Okay.
Now, pro tip, if you're going to ask people for money, don't have scratch cards visible on you, because that right away, if I even had money on me last night, I would not have given him the money because he clearly has proven that he doesn't know how to spend money because he spends it on scratch cards.
Right. He doesn't need it for food or anything if that's what he's spending his panhandling money on.
Yeah. So I'm not helping to contribute to somebody's gambling problem. You're going to be on your own with your gambling problem. Another open mic here about illegal immigration in the state of Florida.
Hey Joe, the wages in Florida are low because of the illegals. Wow. So if they get rid of the illegals, we're going to get paid more, right?
Yes.
So, but you think the business will take the loss?
Yes.
They will not take the loss.
No, they'll pass it along to customers.
I just want to see, like, if there's a hurricane, when the roofs, the shingles blow, you think, you know how much the roof is going to cost now? That the legal people are going to do it? I want to see that.
Yeah, you will see it, because roofing companies are not going to go out of business because they can't find any employees. They will have no choice but to either pay employees a lot more or innovate and come up with technology that will replace illegal immigrants. We cannot let the threat from illegal immigrants, be it you're not going to be able to find employees or they're going to turn to crime. We cannot let the threat from illegal immigrants change the American way of life, period. And we'll leave on that note. Have a great night. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thanks for watching on our Facebook page. Coming up next, it's the third hour of the Sean Hannity Show. Stick around.